Imagine having so many children, you could run a factory. That's what Moulay Ismail's family looked like. He was a brutal emperor of the Moroccan Alaouite dynasty from 1672 to 1727, and he was reported to have had at least 1,171 children. But he wasn't the only one who used his power to sleep with hundreds of women, whether they were interested or not. Other rulers like Augustus the Strong and Genghis Khan had hundreds of children. And while these were some of the more ruthless rulers of their time, it raises a more fundamental scientific question. Women can reproduce for about half their lifetime and can only give birth about once every year or so. So it makes sense that women can only have a fraction as many children as men. One study estimated that women can have around 15 pregnancies in a lifetime. And depending on how many babies she gives birth to at a time, a woman can probably have around 15 to 30 children max. But the most prolific mother ever, according to Guinness World Records, was Miss Fyodor Vasilyev in 19th century Russia. She's said to have given birth to 69 children over 27 pregnancies. That's a lot for one woman. But that's nothing compared to our friend from earlier, Moulay Ismail. According to records, he had 4 wives and 500 women in his harem. But there are factors that not even an emperor can control, like how a man's sperm becomes less mobile and more abnormal as he grows older, which ultimately reduces his chances of fathering children later in life. In fact, studies suggest that men over 50 have an up to 38% lower chance of impregnating a woman compared to men under 30. For Ismail, he fathered most of his children relatively young. So by age 57, he had an estimated 1,171 kids. But he wasn't the only man in history with tons of progeny. Augustus the Strong was king of 18th century Poland, and he had a long-distance relationship with his wife. So of course that didn't stop him from fathering a rumored 370 children by mistresses. And Genghis Khan, notorious for conquering large areas of 13th century Asia, is estimated to have had between 1,000 and 2,000 children. In fact, by tracking types of Y chromosomes, scientists estimate that up to 16 million men today who live in regions that Khan conquered could have been descendants of him or his close male relatives. But did these men really reach their maximum human possibility? Turns out the records on Ismail only spanned 32 years of his life. By one calculation, he really could have had hundreds more. If you compare that to men in more modern times, the most prolific fathers today have about 200 children. That's nowhere near 1,171, and honestly, it's probably for the best.